oh my god, oh my god, are you kidding me? He was not the one. I mean, his shoes, like, it was so disrespectful. So it's a no to him, and it is on to the next.
Baby, you should know this.
That I ain't going.
Going
nowhere. I ain't blowing no smoke. I mean, I've been sober, but you should have known it. I wasn't going.
Calls, long nights. You used to be down for the ride. So please forgive my surprise when you flip the script on me, blaming me for everything wrong in your life. I keep replaying your sound bites, and baby, it don't even sound right. No, think it's time that we make a change.
Welcome back to another video. I am so excited to be filming this vlog. My last vlog went up on Sunday, so do go and check that out. And welcome to another vlog. My name is Brandy, and this is My Trans Life. In my last vlog, I talked about my first date on Hinge. You know, I spoke about the date when I got back from it, and I thought, you know, what would be the harm in going to see a jazz show with this guy, because that's what he invited me to do afterwards. But then I remembered, like, I don't want to waste anyone's time, just like I don't want anyone wasting my time. Time is so precious. So I've decided that I'm not going to see this guy again, just because he's not the one for me, and I'm looking for the one, so there's no point in, like, I was talking to a girlfriend, she was like, well, maybe you can go as friends. And in that moment, I remembered, like, I'm not looking for a male friend. Do you know what I mean? Like, I am looking for a partner in life. So that's it. Back to swiping and going from there. I also am working on not saying the word because as I edited my video back, it's like I am saying so many times. So anyway, this is the outfit from my haul from H&M. This is the top. This is the oversized male's turtleneck. And then I'm wearing my regular black trousers. I'm going to wear my Balenciaga tennis shoes. And we're headed out today. I completely ran out of foundation. Like, completely. Like, till the last drop of my foundation came out, that's what I used today. So as you can see, my concealer's a little bit lighter under the eye today because I had to use concealer on, like, different spots and blend that in with the foundation in order to get some coverage. So I needed to lighten up my concealer today so that it didn't look so even tone. But yeah, I'm headed out to work today. I will definitely be stopping past Sephora because I need to get some foundation. I'm interested to try the Dior foundation. I see it on people and I love it, but I don't know about my skin tone. So I'm definitely gonna go and look at it and see if I like it. If I have time today, I'll have to make time actually. Then I'm also going to try the Charlotte Tilbury foundation. I wanna see what it looks like on my hand and then obviously if I like it. Cause I have to buy a foundation today no matter what. So I have to pick which one I like. There we go again. I do have a friend coming to my apartment this weekend because to celebrate her birthday, and I'm excited for that. This is a long time, old time friend. We have a lot of history together, so it's like family and it's just a no-brainer. But also it's like I have become so me over the years that, like, I don't know how I like people in my space. I just like my space, you know, I like my space, but I wouldn't do this for just anyone. So because we have such a long history, I'm excited. And also, no one comes to see me. I know I spoke about that before. Like, my family will ask me when am I coming to see them, but no one has ever come to see me, and I've been to see them several times. So this is a gesture that I really appreciate, especially around the holidays. So I'm open to it and I'm optimistic that we're going to have a lot of fun. We're going to brunch on Saturday. And also, it's like, it's just a weekend. So that's like 2 days. So it's not really the biggest deal. Obviously, we'll be drinking at brunch. So it'll be fun. I'm super excited for it. Yeah. I'll film some of that, I hope. I obviously want to be careful with putting people on this channel because I want to make sure that, like, I'm staying true to it being my trans life, but some people fit into my trans life, so if they want to be involved, then that's on them, but we'll see. I need to get a mic for this camera because my audio is just so echoey. It's so echoey, and I don't know what to do about that other than get a mic, so I'm going to get a mic, but I see other people with this exact camera, and their audio isn't echoey, so I don't know what that could be. Maybe I'll watch some YouTubes and see if it's like a setting I can change. Who knows? If you know, leave me a comment and let me know. And we're gonna head out for now, and I'll see you guys in a bit. Okay, so I made it to work. I'm having a cup of coffee. I have the cinnamon bun creamer in there from Trader Joe's. And then I also stopped off, as you guys saw in the little montage, at Black Seed Bagel. Now, Black Seed Bagel is this place in Brooklyn, and they have like these super, I guess, like fancy bagels, I guess. But this one's greasy, so I don't know what's going on. But this one is turkey and egg. Let's see. Turkey and egg. I asked for the egg not to be runny because I don't like runny eggs. So, yeah, that's that. Let me get some hot sauce. I like hot sauce in mine. Okay, so I like hot sauce on everything. And so this one is the Oh Brothers hot sauce. I get this from Whole Foods. This is the only hot sauce that's actually, can you guys see that? There you go. This is the only hot sauce that is actually hot anymore. I feel like when I was younger, everything was spicy. It's so hard to find spicy food now. So let's get into this bagel. Let's see what it's giving. Let's clear some of this egg out because I do not like runny yolk, honey. Ugh. Ugh. I'm not judging people who do, like, you know, you like what you like, but for me, it is a no. And I don't judge people for what they do as far as food-wise, but I'm one of those people, if I don't like it, I don't like it. And, you know, I really, like, sometimes when you're with someone eating, like, especially if you're in a relationship or a friendship or something, and people are like, why don't you just try it? How do you know if you don't like it? Because I know. Because I know I don't like it, and I will not be trying it. So, all right, a little hot sauce. Let's give it a try. It's actually so good. Going to work. I'll see you guys in a bit. Good morning. We are back. I am going to electrolysis today, so we're headed there. I slept in just a little bit, and girl, let me tell you something, Miss Mary. I was like, why in the world would you sleep in knowing that you had things to do? So I'm up now, and we're getting ready to go to electrolysis in Williamsburg. This girl, Julia, she's not going to let me film in there, but I'll definitely get some content of the outside. But she is, I've been seeing her, I see her like maybe 3-4 times a year. I don't do electrolysis much because I've had full face laser, so I just do touch-ups. But I, this neck, honey, this neck, she has to get this neck. She helped me last winter. She did my neck, and so we're back now that the weather's cold, and I'm not doing a whole bunch of treatments on my skin. So that's what that's giving. Also, I do not like this lens. I feel like I have no range. Let me just, hold on. Yeah, there is no range with this lens. I am so far back. So, girl, I just keep piling on the things that I need, but I just need them. Like, I need a good lens, something that gives me more, like, I don't have to be all the way back here yelling, because then that messes up the audio. Honey, when I tell you, so I told you guys that I was trying to find someone to make an intro video for me. Well, that was unsuccessful because I was using Upwork, and like a lot of the people are like in other countries, and it just, I don't know, it just seemed a little shady almost. So I was like, you know what, being the strong trans woman that I am, I was like, I'm going to figure it out. So I made this cute intro, which you probably saw already at the beginning of this video. I'm so proud of it. I did it on CapCut. Well, I also made a couple on Canva because they have templates. So I imagine like some girl or some person used the templates already, or it was their original intro and then they shared the template, but it was super easy for me to do. Let me know in the comments if you like the intro. Yeah, I'm super excited for that too. And I'm like, I can't stop watching it. You ever do something? You ever like be creative and like, or take a photo or something and just like be obsessed with your work or who you, what you look like or what you're portrayed as? Let me say it that way, because honey, this is what I look like. Okay, the intro is a little glammed up, but this is what she looks like, honey. This what it gives, Miss Ma'am. This is what it gives. Oh, yes. And it took me a really long, I'm just putting my hair up in a bun because it's greasy and I don't know, I don't want to have it out, so I'm going to lay down and let Julia do my electrolysis. So I just kind of want it out of the way. My hair is growing so much. I constantly have to clip the ends because the density was off. So the length was good, but the ends were all like weak and thin. So I had to like, you know, over time, just cut them off. So now my hair is like, the ends are, now they have like some new heat damage to it, but it's just very small in relative to what it was before. But the density of the hair, wait, let's get some light. There we go. The density of the hair is so much thicker. So it's actually growing pretty healthy as long as I don't let those ends catch up with me. Because what it does is it just like trickles down, and next thing you know, you have like long hair, but very stringy and strands. And if you have natural, if you wear your hair natural like me, that's not going to work. Because it needs to be thick, you know? It needs to be thick, honey, to give you that, you know, that black girl vibe, that black girl essence of beauty. Oh, there we go. And that's all I'm doing to my hair today. I'm just putting it up in a bun. Very middle school, honey, but that's what she lives for. She lives for that. I brush the edges back a little bit. And then the back has a little bit out, too, from the short pieces that don't actually meet the middle. It's not giving baddie hair, but it's giving Brandy's hair, honey. And I love it. And I live for it. Yep. I'm telling you something, I am so much more confident and comfortable in myself, just being myself, you know, like just looking like me, you know. When I go to work, I put on a little makeup and stuff, but I still feel like myself, and I love that about me. I guess some people have that in them, and then other people just like to look gorgeous and and stunning all the time, which I admire so much. This is my coffee with the cinnamon toast. Wait, cinnamon bun swirl? Whatever. Oat milk. It is so good. Trader Joe's. Honey! Okay, so electrolysis today, I don't want to say, I'm just going to see how today goes, but for sure we're going to electrolysis now, and whatever else happens will happen. Yeah, I thought of wearing a Christmas top today, but I was like, next week I'll do that. So let's head out, let's go to electrolysis, and let's see where the day takes us. When I tell you we were just about to pay $25 to take an Uber, and I thought about it. I was like, because I was going to wear like a overcoat, which was super Brooklyn, but I was like, whatever, it's cold. I don't need to look cute. I'm going to take a bike. So we are, and this is always my problem. There's never any electric bikes here. So we are about to take a city bike, but I need to find an electric bike because this can be really bad. So I think we're gonna take that one right here. Yep. When I tell you I am freezing after that bike ride, oh my gosh. Train, train, train! It's so loud. So we're on Broadway, which is in Williamsburg, under a train, under this little path. The place I'm going is right here. We're almost there. Girl, I'm cold. She's gonna have to give me a minute to like thaw out. I could, you know what? I could totally do that bike ride. I just would need to have gloves, particularly ones that are warm, like battery operated almost. Okay, so this is where we're going, honey. It is so Brooklyn. The sign, you can't even like, hold on. There it is, zapped, honey. Under this whole little thingy. Bitch, this is Brooklyn. So we're going right up in here to Miss Zapped to get zapped. So she's usually busy, so what I'll do is I'll just ring that little bell. Usually has to be pretty hard. So anyway, she doesn't like cameras, so let me get started. I'll see you guys in a bit. There's everything. Little wall here with products you can buy. All the things that you might need. Cute paintings. I guess if they're celebrating something, they would open that, not sure. Little holiday candy, not my taste, but cute. And some before and after photos of skin. So you can definitely see those things if you're looking for it. Little sale that they have currently. So we are out of electrolysis now. I was like, that was only a 30-minute session. I used to do 1 hour. When I tell you that I could never do that again, electrolysis hurts so much. But here comes the train. We're going to the Lower East Side, and I'll show you more.
Thank you.
right, so we're off the train. We are now in the Lower East Side. I decided, since it was so early and I got done doing everything, that I'm gonna head on down to Marshall's because I need sheets. So, you know what? Funny story. I used to work right here at this place, and now it's a cafe. I wanna see what it looks like inside. Wow, I'm gonna send this video to all my coworkers because it actually was a place of work for me. So I thought that was fun. A cafe, huh? Oh, wow. What kind of cafe is it? Huh, nice. Huh, so funny. Okay, we're coming up on Cat's Deli. Super famous, like when how Sally Met Harry or whatever the hell that is was there. I've been there several times. And now we head to Marshall's for our little errands, and that'll be it. I don't want the jar though. I kind of just want the pad refills. Huh. I actually do need this. Well, not this big thing. So we'll go with that one. It is crowded in here today. Could have got that one. How cute is that? And this one too. It's like a whole bag of them. I actually like this more than the rest. $10. With this one is $19.99. Okay, let's get into that. So this one is a beauty blender pack of two, and I imagine that's the cleaner. It could just be the brand itself, but that's $19.99. Okay, and this is a whole entire bag of blenders, and this one is $9.99. So this one's a no-brainer. The little cart here, well, that's broken. So we'll take that one. Okay, so the real tea is that whenever I'm here, I don't know what it is, but I'm always like watched. And I just look so basic. So it cannot be, you know, the typical thought process. But we're just gonna keep going and see what we can get. Plenty of holiday things right here. That's your sweet. How cute are those for dinner on Christmas Day? I never really buy into things like that because it's a one day plate. How chic. This will be nice. But I don't need anything from here, so it's best for me to stay focused. Spend way too much money here. Oh, here we go. Bed sheets. You guys know my bedroom is like white and gray. That'll do. But maybe here is better. Okay, this one's better. So let's look, because I always get so overwhelmed. I typically would do this one, but I'm gonna try to do something different this time. We we just can't do green. Green will not work. But that's a cute set. A little holiday inspired. Yeah, I think I'm gonna do this. Reindeers. Naturally, I want to do this. Oh, I don't like polyester. Okay, we're going to do this one. We're going to stick to what we know and go with this. Cute. Let's get a cover, too. I guess we're out of luck for that, but let's check. Aha, here we go. That's what we need. Now we just need it in a size queen, which that is. But let's see. Oh, for sure we're gonna do this one. Tempur-Pedic pillow top. Definitely. We could totally benefit from like a pillow situation. But I'm not going to carry all of that stuff. Every time I'm here, I have to pick up something for the dogs. So let's make sure we do that. And I want something that they like. You know what I mean? Like, preferably a toy. This would drive me crazy. I think we should do it, actually. $5.99. We have to. It's a lobster. It's cute. What goes in here? Let's see what this does. $4.99. Huh. I don't think that that would serve a purpose in my house. Look how cute this is. Oh, Lucy would love that. We're going to do this one, actually. $5.99. Okay, so two toys. And we'll do that. And then that'll be it. I think this is so grand, but I would never do it. But I do like it. So chic, just for like a salad for one on a day-to-day. When I get a dishwasher. Oh! It's always me. Stanley Dupe. Nespresso one shot. Now, it would be great if they actually had the pods. Let's see if they have pods. Home from running those errands. What a cool day. It was cold, but we got a lot done. We did electrolysis today. Now, if you don't know about electrolysis, it's for hair growth. So electrolysis, the way that it differs from laser is that the electrolysis is done through a needle. And what the technician does is she'll go in hair by hair, individually hair by hair, literally grabbing the hair and then using a needle and then shocking the root with electricity, and it kills it. Now, the difference between laser hair removal and electrolysis is that electrolysis is permanent. So each hair that the electrolysis gets, that will never grow back. So it's more effective than laser. Both of them are highly effective treatments, but electrolysis is just more for the long term. Like, your hair will never grow back in that area once it's done. Laser will permanently remove some hair, but it just lessens the hair. So we know that hundreds and hundreds of hairs come out of one root, right? It's like a plant. It sprouts out all these different roots. And so what happens is hair will still grow back, but each time it's closer to killing the actual root, right? The actual root ball, I guess. I don't know. So here's what it looks like. So listen, if you, I don't know if you can see it. She did a really good job today, but I know you can see like these little like swells where it's swollen. So she got a lot of them. We did the neck, along the neck, because the neck is like my problem area now. I don't shave my face at all. I used to have a full beard. So, you know, I have come light years. I don't have a hair growth problem anymore because the laser really did a really good job. These dark spots you see, like the hyperpigmentation, just comes from years and years of laser and electrolysis. But I'm to a place now where little tiny fine hairs grow out sporadically. They don't grow together. It's not giving full beard or anything like that. But there will be, and I think that's pretty normal too. Like, cisgender women have that as well. But I'm finally at a place now where I'm confident enough in myself that I can talk about it without feeling like it questions who I am. Because, you know, it's just the anatomy, it's just who I am, and, you know, I'm doing what I can to take care of it. So it's not as debilitating as it used to be for me, because, honey, I mean, I was debilitated by hair growth. So anyway, let's get into a little haul of the things that I got after that. The first thing I got from Marshalls is this pillow topper, Tempur-Pedic pillow topper. I needed this so bad, so I'm excited. It's cool, breathable, 400 thread count cotton top fabric. So, stain release technology, Tempur-Fit, I don't know what that means. Stretch skirt fits mattress up to 18 inches, machine washable, limited time warranty. So we'll see about that. But it was only $39, so I'm really grateful for that. I love Marshalls for those reasons. I'm going to put this on my bed. I guess you guys will see that in the next vlog because my bed is already made and the sheets are clean. And plus, when I make my bed, like when I change the sheets, I like to clean my whole apartment. And honey, that's not happening tonight. By the way, I am so proud of myself. The last time I was in at Marshalls, I had a full-blown anxiety attack because, like, they were watching me and following me around and stuff, and it just made me feel so uncomfortable. Obviously, you know, I get it. I dress kind of bummy, to be honest with you, when I'm running errands. If I'm not going to work or going out, I am just dressed like a bum, almost, but clean. So I get it. You know what I mean? I get it. I understand that they probably thought that, like, I was there to steal or something. But the level of harassment that I felt that time, like, sent me to, like, an anxiety moment. So I'm so proud of myself this time. And I honestly, for the first time, I think the camera helped. I think the camera helped because I felt power in having that camera. I was thinking to myself, go ahead and do it this time. But I wasn't recording anyone. As you guys can see, I was recording myself. So I got this beauty blender set here, which I need so bad because I have one and I'm currently using it for several different things. I'm using it for liquid blush. I'm using it for concealer. So I don't want to do that. I want to change it out for a different color liquid blush and then also for under eye concealer. So these little eggs here are so cute. Look at the color. Wow, it's so aesthetically pleasing to my apartment right now. So I got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 of these for $9.99, and the other one had like 4 in it, and it was like $20. So I don't know what that was about. And I get this cute little bag, which I'm obsessed with. I got a pair of sheets. Also, we'll be putting those on the bed when we change the bed out, which will be on Sunday, or maybe Friday because someone's coming in town. I'm not necessarily that they're going to sleep in my bed, but I won't be able to do it on Sunday, if that makes sense. So I'll clean my apartment on Friday and do my laundry and stuff on Friday versus Sunday because someone's coming. So I got a sheet set. Really cute polka dot. It's super simple. You know, I like everything to be a bit muted. You know, I live in the hood. It's not like I live in this fancy apartment or anything like that. So I just try to make myself feel as clean as I can, obviously. Sometimes there's a huge disconnect because when I leave the building, like, I I work in a super fancy place. I frequent super fancy places. But when I come into my apartment building, it's giving, girl, this is the hood. So, but then I come in my apartment, it's still the hood, but it's like clean, spacious, it's not cluttered. Yeah, so this will do it for me. I dream of a beat bougie apartment one day where I can just like have all these things and like feel like I actually feel inside, like actually feel my living that way. But that's happening because, honey, God got me. Always watching Aaliyah's face, her last vlog. I'm obsessed with her. Aaliyah, you can do no wrong. I know that's right, honey. Speak to girls like me, please. You made it feel like everything was, for a purpose. She went on this thing about, she was in Morocco, and she really made me feel like, wow, because you're not going to see a lot of influencers who start just like I'm starting right now, and years later after they built their empire, which is like, I celebrate that, especially for black women. Like, black women who do it, like, that makes me so happy. But to hear her say that she doesn't really see it for the facade of it all, you know what I mean? And if you look back at her content, you know that she built her journey based on time and just dedication. And, like, if you put all you have into something and you continue to do it, hard work will pay off and you will be successful. And that's what she has, you know? And I love that she said that because it really separates her from a lot of people just in the mindset, you know? Because a lot of people also forget the journey, I think. A lot of people will forget it and, you know, just operate in that mindset, which I'm sure she does too, operate in that mindset, but she remembers. And that's amazing. You can go back and see her, that last vlog, but what she was saying is that, you know, people want to know real stories. People want to see growth in people. So I was like, oh my God, Aaliyah's face, that's for me. So anyway, I got this for the doggies, a little lobster, which they're back there crying to come play with now, but they have to wait. I also got them this little knot Christmas toy. How cute is this? And this one has no, oh, I guess it does have a squeaky. But isn't this so cute? Look at that. Gorgeous. Listen. And lastly, I got them some wipes, which I'm going to do now. I'm going to wipe them down because we did go for a little walk. I already washed their paws, but I'm going to wipe their face and stuff off too because we live in Brooklyn. And girl, we know the streets are dirty here. So that's it. I am so grateful for you guys for staying around. And if you made it this far, please do not forget to subscribe. Like this video, share this video, comment down if you have any questions about trans-related issues that you would like for me to talk about. I am loving the fact that I'm growing already in my own self, and I just want to talk more about issues that people might be experiencing, or, if, you know, especially people who come across trans people like me, who are just normal people living a normal life, not a baddie, not giving you all of that, but just trying to be normal and exist. Like, there's a story to be told. There's a lot to be told. And you know, you never know what the right thing to say is. And I get it. Like, you never know what the right thing to say is or what questions to ask. So that's what this platform is going to serve for now. And I will be touching on all trans-related issues and stuff coming up. So thank you so much for watching. And I will see you guys in the next video.